Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are going to fix a super common issue on Windows 11. The error message that says security or firewall settings might be blocking the connection. This can pop up when you are trying to use apps like Microsoft Teams, Skype, or even just your browser. So let's walk through all the steps to fix it. All right, first things first, let's check if your firewall is blocking the connection. Click on the Start button, then type Windows Security and Dominate. Once you are there, click on Firewall and Network Protection. Now you will see three network types, Domain, Private, and Public. Click on each and make sure the firewall is turned on. If it's already on, don't worry, that's good. We are not turning it off just yet. Next, on the same screen, click on Allow an App through Firewall. A new window will pop up. Click on the Change Settings button in the top right corner. You will need admin permission, so just confirm if it asks. Now look for the app that's giving you the connection issue. Maybe Microsoft Edge, Chrome, Teams, Zoom, whatever it is. Make sure both private and public checkboxes are checked next to the app. All right, now let's test your connection with the Windows Troubleshooter. Go back to the Start menu, type Troubleshoot Settings, and open it. Now click on Additional Troubleshooters, find Internet Connections, then click Run the Troubleshooter. The troubleshooter will try to detect the issue and fix it automatically. Sometimes that's all you need. But if that didn't solve it, let's reset your network settings. This will reinstall your network adapters and set everything back to default. Go to Settings, then Network and Internet, and scroll all the way down to Advanced Network Settings. Now click on Network Reset, hit Reset Now, and then Confirm. Your PC will restart, so make sure you save any work before doing this. After restarting, try connecting again. Still having trouble? Alright, let's disable any third-party antivirus or firewall temporarily. A third-party antivirus can sometimes interfere with Windows settings. Try to disable the firewall or shields just temporarily. Once it's off, test your internet or the app that wasn't working. If it works now, then you have found the problem. Easier, adjust the settings in your antivirus or consider switching to Windows Defender, which is solid on its own. Let's also check the host file, which sometimes gets modified by malware or software. Open a notepad as administrator. Just search for notepad, right-click, and choose Run as Administrator. Now click File, then open and navigate to this location, Windows System Drivers, etc. Make sure to select all files at the bottom, then open the file called Hosts. Scroll down and make sure there is nothing weird at the bottom, like a bunch of IPs pointing to websites you use. If there are, delete those lines and save the file. Another quick thing, make sure the Windows Defender Firewall service is running. Click Windows key or type services.msc and press Enter. Scroll down and look for Windows Defender Firewall. Right-click it and make sure it's set to automatic and is currently running. If not, click Start. Last but not least, let's flash your DNS and reset Winsock. Key open command prompt as administrator, search for CMD, right-click and select Run as Administrator. Now type the following commands one by one and press Enter after each aep config /flush DNS, netshipble winsock reset, netshipble in aep reset. Now type the following commands one by one and press Enter after each ipconfig/release, ipconfig/renew. After running all of these, restart your PC again, and that's it. If you followed all the steps, your connection issue should be gone. Let me know in the comments which step worked for you. If it's still not working, drop your error message below and I will try to help out. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss more tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.